Hi all, welcome to another video of Adobe Experience Manager in action with me, Veena Vikraman. So today I want to discuss about multiple service implementation. So basically, while attending few of interviews, I was asked this very common question by most of them, that how will you reference a specific implementation of a service if that service has multiple implementation. So to make it a little more clear, let's say you have one service and for that service you have more than one implementation which you have written. It could be for a particular business scenario, right, where you might have to have multiple implementation of same service. Since I have not worked with multiple implementation of same services, most of the time because of the kind of business requirements I have worked with, I have never got much chance to do that or, you know, explore more on that. I mean, I was aware that we can do that and people do it a lot in their projects, but I was not aware of a real use case. There are people who are for that, like having multiple implementation for a service. There are people who are against having multiple implementation of the same service, which I came across while going through forums and things like that. But then it is not that you cannot do it or you should not do it. So depending on your use case, you can write multiple implementations for your service. Now, when you write multiple implementation for your service, how will you invoke a specific implementation? That is the question. You have a service A and you have service B implementing A and C implementing A. Now, when you do at reference of A, you will get both. You are eligible to get both B and C, but then how will you specifically get B or specifically get C? That's what we will see in this video when we talk about multiple service implementation. So to put things very clear, we will first write interface, then we will write two different implementations, and then we will see how we can call one particular implementation, and also at the runtime, how can you choose which service implementation you want to reference in your project. So that we will see in this video. So without much ado, let's go and see how this is done, right? Okay, so for learning purpose, we will first write one interface. I have actually written one. There's nothing but you just have to write an interface. You can write, you can give whatever name to your interface. It's just a learning service. This is only for learning. I have written a public interface export builder and just said get export. Now for this you have to write implementation. So now let's write two implementation for this. So let's call the first one HTML export builder. So it has to implement our export builder. Also, we need to implement all the interface methods. We will add a logger. Now, in this, we will just say that log.info. Okay, you can write all your custom logic inside this. Doesn't matter. Now, this doesn't make this a service. So you have to add a component annotation and tell which service you are implementing. So you have to say export builder dot class. What I want to do is to have the service executed for a particular type. It's all custom property. In the custom property, you will add a set of properties. You can define the property, okay? It doesn't matter. So you can say property and then you can just say what is the key and what is the value of the property. You have your property type and HTML associated with this particular implementation. Now let's write another implementation and let's call it as PDF export builder. Let's do the same for that. Implement all the classes. Let's add logger and let's this. We will just say log.info type equal to PDF. Okay. Now this is ready. Now once this is ready, I have a servlet. I have registered the servlet in a path because this is just a demo. I just want to show a few things. Now in this servlet, we will try to first reference export builder, and what we will be doing is we will call that export builder dot get exporter. Why? Because we already have a log function inside that. So now what I'm going to do is I'll clean install this into my AEM instance. So this is going to install it in my AEM instance. So now this is installed. Once this is installed, what we are going to do is we will call this servlet. So I'm not outputting anything. I am just outputting it to my log. Let's see what is coming in. So our HTML export builder is getting called. So if you have multiple implementation of the same service, there will be a ranking associated with it. Normally, as per the definition, the service which gets registered latest is what which gets called every time you do at reference to a service which have multiple annotations. So I have rerun this thing and we will get the same HTML export builder. Now, how do you get PDF export? So now for that, what you have to do is we have given a property called type equal to PDF. So that is the property with which we can identify the service. So how can we explicitly call this while referencing? So we have to target. Right, we have to target it. So let's add the target, and when you add the target, you have to add it inside a quote, and then you can just tell the property you want to target. Okay, so this is the property you want to target. This means that there is a service implementation which has a property type equal to PDF. Target that particular service and get the reference of that service. Now let's run this and let's go back to our logs. Now we have PDF export. Now let's do this export PDF builder. Now we'll make this export PDF, PDF builder. Now what we want to do is to target the HTML one. So now we will use the same logic and we will say HTML builder export HTML builder and we will run this. Let's clear the logs. Okay, that's installed and we will call this file reload and see. This is a PDF exporter. This is the HTML export builder. So we got both. That is how we will do multiple implementation of a service and specifically call those services depending on any property. Okay. Now let's say at runtime we want to target or reference a particular implementation. When I say that, that means right now in whatever code I am writing, I should know what service I want. But what if I don't know what service I really want? Only at the runtime I will be able to make the decision which service I want to call or reference. So for that, what we are going to do is we will make a map of all the services and call the required services as per the requirement. For that, same way, let's write a servlet. Now I have a servlet already written. I'll explain what we are doing here. So first thing what we have to do is let's do this step by step. What you have to do is you have to create a map. Okay, so you have to create a map of your export builder. So that map will be of type string and your export builder services which we are trying to reference. Okay, so what we have to do first is we have to initialize a map. Now this map should reference our service which is our export builder service in this sample. Right now, now this export builder can have multiple implementations, right? So the policy which should be attached to this is dynamic, that means this component will start when the references are available or not. But whenever a new reference is available, it will take that reference. Okay, now since we have multiple references or multiple implementation of the services, we have to define the cardinality of the services. So the cardinality of the service will be multiple. That means there can be more than one service implementation attached to it. Now we should define the bind method names and unbind method names for this service. So bind method will be bind export builder, and our unbind method will be unbind export builder. Unbind export builder. Now our map is ready. Okay, now what we have to do is to write the bind export builder and unbind export builder. Now what we have to do in bind export builder is we have to write this bind export builder. This bind export builder will take two arguments. One will be our service and the other will be the properties associated with this. Now inside the bind export builder, what I am doing is just building the map. So the properties, I know the properties will have type. There is only one property associated with every service, so that is type. And so we are saying get the type and add it as the value and as the key for the map, and for every key add the corresponding service as its service reference. Okay, so once your export builder is ready, what you can do is, okay, in let's try what we will be doing is while calling the servlet, we will pass type equal to HTML or PDF. So you will say get parameter type not equal to null. If the parameter is not empty, then what we are going to do is get the parameter. Now what we have to do next is we have to, so let's say we have HTML pass. Now we have the property HTML in our service, so that service is already added to our export map. Now we have to get it out of the map. But what if we are passing some invalid type, right? So we have to check if our map contains this, right? Dot contains key type. If it has this key, then only do this, right? If it has that key, we get the export builder, export builder map dot get type. Okay, now if it has that key, we will get it and we will call the export builder dot get exporter, and we will say response dot get writer dot write. If that's a wrong type, we will say response dot. Now let's see, we will run this, we will call the servlet. So this is our servlet path. Pass type equal to, let's pass some invalid type, no valid type. So we will pass HTML. Now fetch the service, check the logs. Let's go and check this log. So now it has fetched HTML exported. Let's clear this and we will pass PDF here. Okay, let's see. So we have the PDF exporter. Now let's pass HTML. Now we have HTML export builder. Now let's do something. So it says no valid type passed, and that's how at runtime you will fetch a service which has multiple implementation. Okay, does that make sense? Hope this has helped. This is a common question or a common concept which everybody expects you to know. So I think this might have helped you. Thanks for listening to this. Thank you. Have a good day. Stay safe.